Welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about constructs and critical perspective on development. And this topic is very important for CTET, KVS, NVS, STET and other teaching exams. So let us discuss that topic. First of all, a psychologist named as Jean Piaget showed that intelligence is the result of a natural sequence of stages because it develops as a result of changing interaction of a child and its environment. It means that if we are seeing that the child has an interaction with the environment, then a sequence of stages will develop and it will be a result of the intelligence of the particular child. So he devised a model on which he describes that how humans go about making a sense of their world by gathering and organizing the information. In that concept, Piaget said that development is a spontaneous process tied to embryogenesis, whereas learning is provoked by external situation. This is the particular concept that is given by the Swiss psychologist Jean Piaget. He also said that in general, learning is provoked by some situation, and that's why we are going to discuss about the psychological experimenter. Or the psychological experimenter can be a teacher, that is the teacher which dictates something, the teacher which dictates something, they have an influence of the child with the external situation, as we can say that it is a spontaneous process. That's why. Moreover, he also described that the cognitive development is much more than the addition of new facts and ideas to an existing stores of information. And according to Piaget, our thinking process changes radically. That thinking process that we are saying, that this thinking process are changing radically. The thinking process that we have got just changed. And the changes is sudden. We can change our thinking process by the influence of some other objects also. So Swiss psychologist Jean Piaget discussed about the embryogenesis. That what is embryogenesis? Embryogenesis concerns the development of the body as well as the development of the nervous system and the development of mental functions. It means that if an organism have some development in their body, the development can be seen as the development of nervous system, and also he has some development of mental functions. Then these are all illustrated by a particular term, and that particular term is said to be embryogenesis. That is the concept of embryogenesis. Again, he also described that some are the factors, there are some factors by which it has an influence in our thinking processes. So once upon a time, one child was asked that what are the four factors identified by Piaget that interact to influence thinking. Then the answer is given by the teacher that there are four factors which can influence our thinking process according to Jean Piaget. The Jean Piaget was a Swiss psychologist. He said that the four factors are: the first factor is maturation, the second factor is activity, the third factor is the social transmission, and the fourth and the last factor is equilibration. We have to understand about the maturation, the activity, the social transmission and the equilibration. Let us understand about the four factors which can affect our thinking process, which have an influence of our thinking process. If you broadly say about the term that is maturation, then maturation is the unfolding of the biological changes. Maturation is what? Maturation is the unfolding of the biological changes that are genetically programmed. If the biological changes are genetically programmed, then this is called the maturation. Like the parents and teacher have a literal influence on this aspect of cognitive development, except to the certain that children get the nourishment and care that they need to be healthy. So they are matured, that they know that if they are getting nourishment, then they can be healthy. So this is the particular thing that we are saying, that it is maturation. So maturation means the maturation is the unfolding of the biological changes, the biological changes that are happening in the environment are just unfolded by the biological by the genetically determined programmed. That genetically determined programmed unfolds our biological change. That's why we are saying that maturation is the unfolding of the biological changes that are genetically programmed. The second thing is the activity. Activity. We have to know about the activity. With maturation, once the child is get matured, then with maturation, it comes the increasing ability. It means that if the child is matured, that then the particular child has some ability also, by which it can act to the environment, and from the environment the child can learn. Like when a young child's coordination is reasonably developed, then the child may discover some principle about balancing by experiments. Okay, so this is a particular concept, that if the child get matured, then the ability of the particular child got increased, and if the ability of that particular child got increased, then that particular child will act with or against the environment, and from which they can learn many things. The next thing is social transmission. Social transmission is a process, and this process of development also involves interacting with the people around us. Like we have many peoples in our surrounding, that peoples have some influences with us. If we have some influences with that particular people, then we are getting developed. So the process of development also involves interacting with the people around us. And according to the Swiss psychologist that is named as Jean Piaget, our cognitive development is very much influenced by the social transmission or learning from the others. So the amount of people that can learn from social transmission varies according to their stage, like the first stage or the second stage or the third stage and so on, the cognitive development stage. The last concept was equilibration. That what is equilibration? Actually, the equilibration, broadly we say that the equilibration is the actual changes in the thinking. If some changes are involved in our thinking process, then it will be the result of equilibration, because it can act as a searching of the balance. Briefly, we can say that the process of equilibration works with the process of thinking. Okay, so these are the four terms and the terminologies that were described by the Swiss psychologist Jean Piaget. After that, we have a next concept, that if there are some invariant functions of thinking, then what are they? What are the invariant functions of thinking? Piaget has suggested two invariant functions. The first invariant function was said by the Piaget as the organization, and the second was adaptation. Let us understand about organization, what are organization? Organization, that if we say that we are born with a propensity to organize our thinking process with the biological structures. Then these structures are our systems for understanding the world. Since these structures are some systems which help us to understand about the world, that's why, according to Swiss psychologist Jean Piaget, these understanding of the worlds or these structures are termed as schemas or schemes. Simple structures are continually combined and coordinated to become a sophisticated, and it will thus become more effective. If we say that in the concept of Jean Piaget's theory, that schemas or schemes are the basic building blocks of thinking. Like if we have some thinking process, then that thinking process involves some schemes, that is the schemas, as suggested by Jean Piaget. The next concept was adaptation. Adaptation takes place when people use their existing schemes, okay, or when the person's existing scheme got changes with the situation. So there are two conditions with it, that people will inherit the tendency to adapt with the environment through some complementary processes. And that's why the adaptation got divided into two processes. The first process is called assimilation, and the second process is called accommodation. So we have to understand about assimilation and accommodation. Assimilation, it takes place when people use existing schemes to make sense of events in their world. Like if we have some senses, and that senses is generated by the existing schemes that are present already in the environment, then this is called the assimilation. Some schemes are got developed when a person changes the existing schemes, and just because of that, they respond to a new situation. This type of situation will call accommodation, because the person get accommodated with the environment.